Let's look at our linear function in a bit more detail. So equation of lines. We know all straight lines can be written in the form y equals mx plus b. M, of course, represents the slope, b, the y-intercept. So just like any polynomial, the pronumeral without the x, the constant, if you like, is the y-intercept. Or sometimes we write it in general form. So that's where we move everything to the one side and make it equal to zero. Now, a, b, and c, we like to make an integer or a surd, of course. I mean, if we're dealing with surds, we can't make them integers, but we basically don't want fractions. Find the equation of the line perpendicular to y equals 5x minus 2, and it passes through 0, 6, and they want it in general form. Okay, well, I know the slope of this line is 5, so the slope of the line I want is minus 1 fifth, and I've got the slope. Well, I've got the y-intercept as well, because they gave us that 0, 6. So therefore, my line is minus 1 fifth x plus 6, but they said in general form. General form, get rid of the fraction. Multiply everything by 5. Now we want to move everything to one side. It is convention to make the x positive. Well, it doesn't have to be, but it's just generally how we do it. So x plus 5y minus 30 is equal to 0. So some special lines. Lines parallel to the x-axis. They will always be y equals some constant number. Let's just draw one in. There's the point 3, 2. Now, what do I know about this line? Well, it's parallel to the x-axis, so its distance to the x-axis is always the same. So its y-value must always be 2, hence the equation y equals 2. A similar thing happens with vertical lines, so lines parallel to the y-axis, going through the same point, but now we know that that horizontal distance will always be 3, so we're getting x values that are always 3. So that's just two very special cases, vertical and horizontal lines. 7C.